He's just saying to a five-tool guy that I've seen in college baseball in a long time.
And that's why Thursday evening, Crystal Springs native and MSU standout Hunter Renfroe is likely to hear his name called in the first round of the Major League Baseball Amateur Draft. A lifelong goal realized, financial stability for his future, but maybe most important, for the first time in a long time, he'll be able to breathe.
I mean, I'm with him every day. We ride together to the field. We live together. So I hear all the phone calls. I know how much pressure the guy's under.
For my parents, it's been the most, you know, just moments than you can possibly think about. You know, they wear me out about it, and they're so nervous about this thing. It's unbelievable, and they make me nervous, and I'm not a nervous guy. You know, I don't get nervous.
Draft day also happens to fall right in the middle of these student athletes' preparations for their run to Omaha. No other sport holds a draft midseason, a change some would gladly welcome.
Absolutely.
Well, I would. I'd like it to be removed, from our season. Like, I would love to see the facial expression at an SEC head coaches meeting if someone brought the fact, hey, we're going to move the NFL draft into December while you're preparing for your bowl game, and just see how that flies.
You know, if I have a kid myself and they go into the same process, you know, I think it'd be need to move a lot further down myself.
When Renfroe hears his name called, he may literally be on cloud nine. That's because there's a strong possibility he could be drafted mid-flight en route to the Super Regional in Charlottesville, but that's not even the most bizarre draft day story for the Dogs.
I remember somebody in our dugout telling me that I had been drafted during the College World Series. That's a strange sensation. When you're playing in the College World Series and somebody said, hey, by the way, you were just drafted by the Minnesota Twins, congratulations.
Yeah, John Cohen, selected 596th overall in 1990, two spots after some guy named Andy Pettit.
Swings and misses, he's down on strikes, three strikeouts in a row for Pettit.
So, airborne, 48 hours from the biggest series of his career, with the weight of a childhood dream lifted off his shoulders. It's possible things could even get better for Renfroe.
He's going to be fine, man. When his name's called, which I'm sure it will be pretty early, I just feel like, you know, the phone call's in, he can really focus in on Mississippi State and just get back to it, man.
It's going to be, you know, a surreal moment when my name is called. It's going to be a great opportunity for me down the future. Once that's over with, it'll be a huge weight lift off my shoulders, you know, go into the Super Regional and be able to focus on that, and I'm going to be going on to the World Series.